Nibak siapa lo lagu lo, dengan niaga lo, suplo kaik, aku begom kengam begom, suplo kaik aku begom silamon, ilah katak tuak silamon. Tipenya.
Big Diomede, Little Diomede, and King Island. And in those three islands are the stepping stones to get to America.
So King Island is this absolutely beautiful place off the coast of Alaska. And if you can imagine being on this really kind of rocky island that kind of shoots up from the water to these cliffs, and then all of a sudden you see these stilts, and then you look up and there are these houses.
They were built on the cliff up high because of the ice. Being an island in the Bering Sea, you have ice that's being pushed by the winds onto the island. So it's going to pile up 50, 60 feet high. Structures are still there today, and people have returned to King Island. It's a growing community as the people return back to their island.
Tamna nunaqiq innitqinaanniqsuq tainnaptaaq pingavlugo ibiaqsiaqaruallum aimaaqviatu
Thank you.
Kikokayat kaumaktit kat nunakit.
When I was young, my mom, whenever the Northern Lights came out, she'd just whistle.
Boy, they come alive. Just keep whistling and that aurora will just like, you know, you can almost hear it.
And then she explained to me a little bit later that passed away when they're children. You don't want to draw them in too much, you know, is what she said, because then they could play football with your head, play Eskimo football, and that's what they want to do. They're always playing, those children up there.
Don't play out without your hood on. If you don't have your hood on, the aurora person is going to come down and chop your head off and play ball with your head.
It wasn't like they were trying to do bad, you know, or it was like a scary story or anything like that. It was just, that's how it was, that's what it was.
Kirwayat siliagahuting silamit. Ibahalik siyot nalakan nila ikyonik. Tukkan na.
In the month of November, there's no sun. So during that dark time, we travel by the light of the moon. It's quite different. Everything was silver and black. Toward the horizon, we could see where caribou are because their body heat flowing upward, and we could see it glowing in the moonlight against a dark horizon where there's no stars. If somebody yelled, you could know who yelled from where the sound came from, but specifically for that cloud of their breath went up and it glowed in the moonlight. So that was a good time to travel. It was very surrealistic. And so things that were dark objects looked very close and white objects looked very far.
Vaxiagalo, Terigan Nablo. At King Matro Imna. When it's Bakimna. Showing a six shark on it. Putting it. Tegan neak alang ngohone magit peksak. Naga tenai tuak adaramik.
We're taught that there's no hierarchy. It's not everything else, and then man, you know, humans on top, and they're separate from everything. We're taught that everything is equal, and that all the animals have a human form, or can be seen in a human form. And so they have just as much or more intelligence, you know, in fact, have a lot to teach people. And so that's how these transformations can happen. It's if the animal wants you to see it in its human form. There's a story where a man comes up to an ice hole and then there realizes there's another man in his parka that's got stuck in the net, you know, and is just stuck like that. Oh, can you let me out? Please help me, you know. And so then he lets the man out, but then realizes that was actually a seal. That was a seal man. And just because that seal wanted that help, that seal allowed itself to be seen in human form.
Hello, Napartut Nurangat. Trigger name connected guy. Canutum. Pepperknock the lang is only. If I use what he could see.
Ah!
Pagtud inyungit salap kehuting. Pakalagat terigan niyak. Suli ikayo hulu niwayak siya alwalu igilagin ingan.
Oh,
we have our dhimmi, the body, which returns to Nuna, the earth. And we have Atik, who is our name, that has been passed down to us over the generations. The spirit of our Atik lives on so long as man remembers that name. It would be hard to describe what happens after death. The feeling is that when our Anirinik returns to Sila, then that may be reborn if the name is passed on to a new child who can then retain some of the memories of the original name.
And so it's not uncommon for grown-ups or adults to meet a child who has the same name maybe as their grandmother and say, "Hi, Akka," which means grandma, "Hi, Appa," or "Hi, little mom," or "Hi, little dad," because it's the traditional belief that the soul, you know, is continuing on.
Humans are renewed and replenished over time. Just like our plants, every year flowers are born and bloom and they die. Next year, they are born again. Thank you.
So a recurring type of character in Inupiaq stories is the manslayer. And the manslayer is kind of this bad guy. And I think really what's at risk when the manslayer comes into story is the livelihood of individuals and the whole community. And so the manslayer is really used as a way to say, don't act only for yourself. Always hold the community in your heart. Oftentimes in these stories, there is one person that will stand up.
And what this humble person will represent who faces that manslayer is a return to order, a return to true living in the community. And it just takes that one person. It could just be that one person that can help to change everything. Because everyone wants to live a good life. Everyone wants to have a good community.
Kangitka ibaktane inyuk pasumarok ulimak tuahalu apun siyamit taranga asi pihirun mik silamun siyamayak titsu siyam mayaktin maung apun ano ka magkuhariga asi aganirok titlugo tunganon nibayak siya karulong ay makabiyano dabura kang itka summan aganirok utilanga. Kanugulunga tagpiguan yaktik. Ibeak siya karuwa lumukallak yaktak. Abulayt kan, at ang chikun mayo ko niya ikpok. Kiwa Terigan.
Thank you.
Ulimauta isumarok nalunaitjok agnek pengarisi Paliramik tikinyak tua ulimautek pak. Tiyum maung ulimautek pak akhralik tuk natkilakatahutik. Inyuk pasum malikatakaloka ang ulayt ka o kilablo ni.
Thank you.
With the story of Kunuk Sayuka, told by Robert Cleveland, it's just a masterwork. It's a well-known story among the Inupiaq people. And in our case, of producing a video game that really reflects indigenous heritage, it captures the imagination, and it's something that you have a very specific kind of task to do. There's a blizzard, you know, and it is just a non-stop blizzard that is overpowering the people. And there's one man that wants to figure it out. And in our case of the story, it's a girl that wants to find the source of that blizzard. The blizzard man, it's like that is the physical embodiment of an element of nature. And so there's a person that needs to go up and take away that adds, that's chipping away that snow.
In that community, the person least expected is the one who stands up and makes the difference.
Humility is something that we value. And where that comes from is the idea that you are not the biggest thing in the world. And when you live in an extreme environment, like where the Inuit reside, you're at the whim of the environment, of the climate, of the animals. You can be as prepared as you can, you know, by learning from your elders that, you know, you're not the biggest force in the world.
Terigan niam nukat piam ukan lautiga neveak seagaroal. Ilan nin inyo neagaloa kovit. Aul lang agaloa kovit. Aisule kovit. It kaksagima. Asita brat out unaik sok. Pauma tak tuamun silam. Dabra ten na nasum unep kaamang tusangariga.